Hi everyone. Today in this video, we are going to understand about estimation of lactic acid. Okay. So this estimation of lactic acid you have in the examination for 7 marks. So estimate the amount of lactic acid from the given sample A. Experiment 3 marks. Principle and procedure 2 marks. Result and calculation 2 marks. Okay. Now let us go through the today's experiment estimation of lactic acid. So what is the aim of the experiment? To estimate the amount of lactic acid in the milk sample by titration method. Principle behind this experiment is very simple. Okay, both lactic acid and citric acid are almost the same. This experiment makes use of simple acid-based titration. The given sample was titrated against an alkali of a known strength with the phenolphthalein as an indicator. The end point was the appearance of a permanent pale pink color. The volume of the alkali used for utilization is accounted to calculate the normality and percentage of acid in the milk. Okay, materials required. We need the milk sample. So I've kept the milk sample ready. We need 0.1 normal NaOH, then phenolphthalein indicator. We need burette. We need pipette, or you can take the measuring cylinder, then conical flask. Okay, so these are the some of the requirement. Now let us go through the procedure. So first, what you need to do, you need to take the 10 ml of milk sample into the conical flask, and to that you need to add 2 to 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Then that solution was then titrated against 0.1 normal NaOH till a permanent pale pink color was obtained, and the volume of NaOH rundown on utilization was recorded. Okay, now let us go through. I've taken the conical flask here. Let me measure the milk sample for 10 ml. Okay, I've taken the 10 ml milk sample here. Put it in the conical flask. Then put a 2 to 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Okay, then titrate against the NaOH. Okay, so you need to titrate in such a way that you need to adjust the burette that drop by drop the NaOH should release to the conical flask. Okay, until you get the permanent pale pink color, you need to do the titration. Once you got the permanent pale pink color, stop the titration, then record the number, how much you got reading. That reading you need to write in the tabular column. While performing this experiment, you need to continuously stir the conical flask for the proper mixing of the NaOH and with the milk. Now I am getting here the permanent pale pink color. Against the white background you can check the white, that is permanent pale pink color. Once you get this permanent pale pink color, you need to record the result. Okay, by keeping to your eye distance, you need to record the result. Okay, this is the procedure. Next, the titration was repeated for concordant values and the amount of acid was calculated by using the calculation. Okay, now let us go through the note. Since the lactic acid is the major acid found in the milk for calculation, the gram equivalent weight of lactic acid was being considered over here. Okay, now let us go through the index. In burette, you have taken 0.1 over NaOH, then conical flask 10 ml of milk sample with the indicator, then indicator is phenolphthalein, we have taken as indicator. Then end point will be colorless to ferment, pale pink color. Now let us go through the calculation part. You can hear trilemma 1 and 2. This is the initial reading 0.00 taken, then final reading I got 1.5, then volume of proton is 1.5. Then again second reading, when I start from 1.5, then I got the neutralization, right, the color development at the 3.0 ml. Then 1.5 will be the rundown of your NaOH. Then N1V1 lactic acid is equal to N2V2 NaOH. N1 is equal to N2V2 divided by V1. When you do this perform this calculation, you are going to get this much amount of the normality. So percentage of lactic acid is equal to normality of the lactic acid multiplied with gram equivalent weight into 100 divided by 1000 will give you the percentage of lactic acid present in that particular milk sample. Now let us go to the calculation part here. I got there 1.5 is the rundown of volume of NaOH. So N2 we have taken normality of the NaOH, that is 0.1. Then V2 is volume of NaOH rundown is 1.5 divided by V1. V1 is the volume of sample taken, that is 10. When you calculate all this, you are going to get 0.015 normality. So that 0.05 normality, you are going to put it here. Normality of lactic acid is 0.015 multiplied with 90 gram equivalent weight of citric acid multiplied with 100 whole divided by 1000. When you do this calculation, you are going to get 0.135%. So the percentage of lactic acid in milk sample is 0.135%. So this is about the tabular column and the calculation part. And at the end, you have to write the result. The percentage of lactic acid in the given milk sample dash percentage you need to write. Hope you understood today's unit, estimation of lactic acid in the given sample. When you focus problem, you lose the good. When you focus on goal, you lose your problem. Think about this. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.